No, no forms. Forms is for the US, yeah, for the US. And then you will have poem. Poem. Poem is, and then the riddle. And then the proverbs. We'll see the one of the. Okay, let's talk about the poem. Okay, have you done this one? You already done, yeah? In the Google, I will check it. Let's discuss it for a while. Would you please read, Dava? Come on, the poem. Dava. Yep. Dava. Ya, kalau nanti masuk dipanggil namanya. Saya keluarin ya. Dava, come on. Would you please read?
In the
spring.
In the early part of spring, you will hear many birds sing. They are just letting the rest of us know. Winter is over. Spring melted the snow. You will notice a beautiful scene. The trees will slowly begin to turn green. Chipmunks and bunnies will come out and play. Bears will no longer sleep during the day. It's exciting when spring finally arrives. Bees will make honey inside their hives.
Hives.
So much hives. So much to do. So much to see. Insects and animals are happy and free.
Okay.
What's the poem about?
About? It's about what?
Nature.
Nature. Okay. Yes. Let's go with number 9. Calvin?
Ma'am.
Yeah. Where is Sharif?
Sharif? Lagi disuruh orang tua kayaknya. Gak aktif ya.
Kemana?
Gak aktif ya.
Hah?
Gak aktif ya, men. Gak tahu kemana.
Yes. Alright, let's go. Number 9. Dava, call Sharif, Dava. Where is he? Jawab, call Sharif. Come on, Calvin.
What is the main idea of the second stanza?
Once again, Calvin.
What is the main idea of the second stanza? Yes, second.
Yes, idea. Repeat after me, idea.
Idea.
Yeah. What is the main idea of the second stanza?
Yes.
Yes. Read the question again.
Oh, what is the second? Mana, ma'am? Sorry, ma'am. Oh, ini. What is the main idea of the second stanza? The second stanza.
Second stanza, you will notice a beautiful scene. The trees will slowly begin to turn green. Chipmunk and bunnies will come out and play. Bears will no longer sleep during the day.
A.
What is?
You will notice a beautiful skin.
You will notice a beautiful skin, yeah? Not skin. Okay.
Yes.
So that's the example for the poem. And then we go with the riddle. What is riddle, guys? Riddle itu apa? What is riddle?
Games.
Games, a puzzle. Okay. Let's go. Let's go with the puzzle. Yep. Let's read. Dosma, where have you been? Evander, come on, Evander. Evander, could you please read the riddle? Yes?
You have me today. Tomorrow, you'll have more. As your time passes,
it's
not easy to store.
Evander, passes.
As your time passes, I'm not easy to store. I don't take up space, but I'm only in one place. I am what you saw, but not what you see. What am I? The memories.
Memories, yeah? Okay. What is the clue? What is the clue, Evander?
You have me today and tomorrow you'll have more.
Okay. Let's go. Yes, memories, yeah? 23. Farza? 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 Fauzan? Fauzan? Fauzan?
Yes.
Yes. Let's go 23.
Who probably most likely to
read the riddle first.
This is something black and white. Mm-hmm. It is not an old TV. It's a type of animal that starts with the letter Z.
Okay, what is it?
It's a zebra.
It's a zebra, okay.
Who probably most likely to use the riddle? Mm-hmm. Be a teacher.
A teacher, okay, thank you. Yes.
Okay.
Okay, that's the riddle, yeah? And then we go with the proverb. What is proverb? What is proverb, guys? What is proverb? Proverb itu apa?
A saying.
A saying? Yes, a saying. In Indonesia, we have this what? Peribahasa, ya?
Yes.
Yes. Peribahasa in Indonesia. Okay, let's see the example. Okay. Okay, let's go with Faisal. Faisal? Faisal. Ini nanti yang gak ada yang ada dipanggil saya keluarin darah.
Halo, ma'am.
Ya.
Putus.
Terus-putus. Yang diputusin, yang sedih. Let's go with number six.
Number six. Better late than never.
Better late than never, okay.
Zoom.
It's actually already done this year in the classroom. Already in the book.
Oh, it's
in the classroom.
D.
D? Better late than never. In Indonesia lebih baik terlambat ya daripada tidak sama sekali. What is? Okay, would you please read one action? Delta.
One action, whether good or bad, determine one's reward or punishment. Punishment.
Is it? No. Any other answer, guys? One action, whether good or bad, determine one reward or punishment. Another action, whether good or bad, one reward or punishment.
Say, ma'am.
Say, ma'am.
Yes.
It is preferable to do a job even if it is delayed than do it at all.
Yes, not doing it so. Walaupun walaupun it's delayed, then not do it at all. Never. Thank you. Let's go, Najma. Najma, seven.
All that glitters is not gold. Yang imam.
All that glitter is not gold.
Yes, everything that is attractive on the outside may not be really valuable inside.
Okay, yes. That's about the proverb, yeah? Now we'll go with the text. Okay, so let's go with the text. So text, generally, text are divided into introduction, body, and closing. Jadi, secara general, semua umumnya itu mereka semua jenis teks. Baik itu exposition, discussion, 1-9 yang ada di sini. They are divided into three, introduction, body, and closing. Kalau exposition itu dia opininya satu arah aja. Dia bisa positif aja atau negatif aja. Sedangkan kalau discussion text, opininya berapa guys? Ada? Dua. Dia opininya dua. Lalu kalau report text itu memberikan informasi secara general. Misalnya dog, dolphin, human. Sedangkan kalau descriptive text, dia spesifik. Contohnya misalnya my dog, my dolphin. If it's about human, it will be Alif, Farza, Fauzan, Jawad, like that. And then biography. Biography is about the life story of someone. Review, to review or criticize something. It can be film, statue, or novel. And then when we go with the narrative, we got the folklore, legend, fairy tales. It's meant for the purpose to entertain or to educate, to get the moral value. We also have the advertisement to make the promotion, the procedure, step to do something, and explanation why something works. You have this in the second grade. Now let's see the example of the text, and you're gonna tell me what is the name of the text. Okay, let's go with this one. Would you please, Alif, what is the name of the text?
It's a promotion, ma'am.
It's a promotion, so it's what?
An advertisement.
An advertisement, okay, thank you.
Yes.
Let's go, Aubrey. Aubrey?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the text is about?
Invitation.
Masa invitation ini? Invite someone. Apa?
Advertisement.
Advertisement. Advertising apa dia?
Largest antique furniture supplier.
Okay, thank you. Let's go next. Karen. Karen, liatin ya kalau ditinggal-tinggal, awas.
Mem, katanya Karen jaringannya itu, Mem.
Oke. Evelinda? Evelinda? Farza? Farza, Gaby, mulai malu sih saya. Gaby, Gab?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, what is the name of the text? Prestigious Trip. What is the name of the text? Gaby-nya hilang. Aurelia?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, what is the name of the text here? Prestigious trade.
Advertisement,
yes. Okay, account banner, ya. Let's go. This one. The view that women are better than itself, blah, 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 throughout. What is the name of the text? Kanaya? Hi, Tanaya. Tanaya.
Yes. Ya, ma'am.
What is the name of the text?
Boleh kebawain nggak, ma'am? Soalnya?
Ini kemarin udah dikasih loh. Yang saya taruh lagi ya.
Oh iya.
Saya taruh di akal yang sambil dibuka. Nah, kemarin udah dikerjain di itu kan? Google Classroom. Oke. Okay. Ambil di WA grup ya. Ya. Anafai.
Ya, si bukan mem to discuss about mother's play.
Nanya jenis teksnya kok, enggak nanya pertanyaan.
Huh? Discussion.
Discussion, enggak discussion-nya. Tesis statement-nya mana? Kalau discussion kan ada dua, Positif negatif. Ayo. Kalau ini apa?
Oh, berarti exposition.
Exposition. Dia positif doang atau negatif doang? Kai. Kana ya?
Positif.
Positif tentang apa? What is the text is about?
Woman.
Woman. Mana thesis statement-nya? Baca di paragraf pertama, di introduction ya.
This view that women are better parents than men has shown itself to be true throughout history.
Okay. Ini ya, berarti ke bawahnya dia bakalan ngomongin apa? Di tengah-tengahnya itu isinya bakalan ngomongin apa?
Parents. Woman
as a parent. Okay. Thank you. Exposition ya. Okay. It's this one. Lintang.
Mem.
Tadi dipanggil kemana?
Gak bisa, mem, sinyalnya.
Naik ke atas pohon. Ya, come on. What is the text is about? Ini, what is the name of the text?
Advertisement.
Advertisement about what? Advertising what?
About visit the festival.
Visiting the festival. Right. Thank you. This is already. Let's go with this one. Marcella. Marcella, what is the name of the text? Marcella, what is the name of the text? Marcella? Okay, si Marcella. Kemana dia? Marcella?
Ya, ma'am.
Ya, yeah, what is the name of the text here? What is the name of the text here? Marcella?
Report bukan, ma'am.
Masa report? Report kan general something. Dogs, humans. Ini apa? Ini mau part ya? Jenis-jenis text-nya aja lupa.
Artikel bukan, ma'am.
Artikel? What article?
Deskripsi bukan, ma'am.
Bisa deskripsi, amit-amit. Lihat di sini.
Is it explanation?
Hah?
Is it explanation?
Eh.
Alright, I'm wrong.
Yes, exposition, discussion, report, descriptive, biography, review, narrative, advertisement, procedure, apa explanation? Dia tentang exposition, ngasih tahu tentang apa?
Nah, tadi siap exposition, ma'am, yang keduanya.
Exposition apa report? Tadi dia yang bilang report.
Kan report saya pertama, terus yang keduanya saya jawab exposition.
Exposition. Why is exposition? Kenapa ini exposition? Ya? Yeah?
Bahas satu arah doang, ma'am, tentang kelebihan yang laptop.
Okay, so, and then the talk is about what? Tentang apa?
Positifnya laptop bukan, ma'am? Atau kelebihan-kelebihan?
Yes, the sentence please. Look from the introduction. Jadi kalau nanti pertanyaan misalnya what is the text about, what is the talks about. Jadi kalau cari semua umumnya, kalian langsung cari lihat di bagian introduction-nya. Ya? Jadi ini tentang apa? What is the text about? What is the text is about? Marcella? Ya?
Yeah? Laptop.
A laptop. Mana kalimatnya? Iya, ini a laptop. Semuanya ngomongin laptop nih. Kata-katanya, oke. Okay. Thesis statement-nya apa? Apa yang diomongin? Tentang laptop apa?
Size-nya, ma'am.
Masa slice-nya?
Portable device.
Device.
Oh God.
Tes statement itu tentang apa?
It's a kind of computer unit.
Hah? Apa gap?
It's a kind of computer unit which has the same function.
Ya, itu kan dia bikin introduction ini. Laptop is a kind of computer, bla 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 bla. Yang bakalan diomongin nanti di bawah ini apa? Tentang apa?
Kelebihannya.
Features.
Kelebihannya? Iya, kelebihannya. Mana kalimatnya?
Di paragraf 3 ada tuh, Mem.
Masa di paragraf ketiga orang masih nanyain tetek is about what? Kalau misalnya nanya...
The function of the laptop, Mem.
The function. Bukan the function lah. Most people choose laptop for several reasons. Kayaknya gimana tuh nanti bacanya? Jadi kalau misalnya mau baca teks, itu kan sebenarnya ada bagi tiga bagian. Ada introduction, body, sama closing. Kalau misalnya ditanya si teksnya tentang apa, masuk langsung ke bagian introduction-nya di paragraf paling awal. Jangan cuma langsung pada kalimat pertama, a laptop is a kind of computer, bla bla bla. Iya, ini memang ngomongin laptop, cuma isinya nanti tentang apa. Most people choose laptop for several reasons. Jadi yang bakalan diomongin nanti di bawah adalah the reason why people choose laptop. Nah, gitu cara bacanya. Baru di tengahnya, ini masuk ke bagian body. Nah, body-nya itu tentang detailnya. Several reason-nya itu apa? Reason-reason-nya apa? Pertama, a laptop is a portable device. Baru nanti dijelasin. Artinya apa portable device, bla 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 bla. Lalu berikutnya, laptop allows us to access the internet in public places. Yang ketiga, dia ngomong, consume more efficiently, laptopnya more efficiently. Nah, yang keempat, baru dia bikin kesimpulan. Nah, ini namanya closing-nya. Gitu. Jadi, semua teks itu sebenarnya intinya adalah ada introduction, ada body-nya, ada closing-nya. Cuman kita diberitahu apa sih bagian-bagian ini disebutnya apa ini? Ini thesis statement, ini arguments-nya, ya kan? Kalau exposition dia ngasih-ngasih opini kan? Iya enggak? Halo?
Iya,
ma'am. Terus yes. Bawahnya baru kasih conclusion. Kalau misalnya si opini, makanya tadi dibilang kalau exposition opininya satu, kalau discussion opininya dua, kalau report dia tentang si general info, misalnya tentang dogs, dolphins, banyak dolphins, spesiesnya dolphin, humans gitu. Lalu kalau descriptive text adalah specific infonya, biografi tentang kehidupan. Sekarang kita lihat berikutnya, contohnya. Kita kenalin dulu aja nama teksnya apa. Ya, berikutnya. Siapa ini? Ya, Wat. Dari mana, Wat? Syarif.
Wifi memang habis rusak. First media ngeheng.
Ya udah, ayo. Ini nama teksnya apa? Udah bisa masuk.
Hah?
Ayo, nama teksnya apa ini? Syarif?
Wait, wait, ma'am.
Baca. Tentang apa dia? Tentang apa?
About ethanol.
About ethanol. Terus apa yang mau diomongin? Etanolnya kenapa? Syarif! Ya. Sarif. Sarif Hidayatullah. Ayo, apa nama teksnya? Si Sarif left. Safira.
Yes, ma'am.
Ini nama teksnya apa?
Exposition bukan, ma'am? Exposition.
Kenapa disebut exposition?
Karena cuman ada apa? Opini yang positif doang itu.
Opini positifnya tentang apa?
Ethanol is a good alternative to the fuel.
Okay. Terus, kan why ethanol is a good alternative to fuel which is now. Terus, apa yang pertama?
Ethanol is based on renewable resource.
Okay. Yang kedua?
Because of its alcohol nature makes the fuel.
Okay, alcohol nature. More efficiently. Terus yang ketiga,
ethanol produce lower emissions of CO and hydrocarbons compared to petrol.
Oke, okay. Karena terus dia opininya cuma satu, berarti nama teksnya apa tadi?
Exposition.
Exposition. Yes, thank you Safira. Next, Sudirman, apa ini nama teksnya? Awas, nggak tahu.
Aduh, ma'am.
Yes.
Naratif bukan, ma'am.
Iya. Tahu dari mana?
Itu di depannya ada tulisan a long time ago.
Iya. Naratif ya, awas sampai nggak tahu ini apa. Berikutnya, Sekina. Sekina.
Yes, ma'am.
Udah jalan-jalan ke Amrik. Kamu masih di mana? Di Amrik atau udah di Indonesia?
Ma'am, please, ma'am. Please, ma'am. Lanjut, ma'am. Lanjut, ma'am.
Nah, oleh-oleh nggak ada. Nggak kirim. Apa ini nama teksnya?
Biografi, ma'am.
Biografi, how do you know it?
What was born on 19 January 1760.
Okay. Yes, the path of the life ya, ada tahun-tahunnya ya. Kayak begini aja, nggak tahu, nggak usah ke Amrik kalau begitu itu. Ya, yeah. Next. Widat. Widat.
Yes, ma'am.
Ayo, udah lama gak denger gitu. Yuk, come on. What is the name of the text?
Itu review, ma'am.
Review. What is the purpose of the review?
To review atau kritis about film or book, ma'am.
Okay, let's go. Kalau ini berarti apa? To apa?
Film.
A film of what?
Breaking and entering is unusual.
Okay, let's go. Nah, sekarang kita masuk ke grammarnya. Grammar yang dipakai di PAT adalah pasif ya. Saya ulang sedikit tentang pasif. Masih ingat kan ya pasif? Masih lah, udah hafal ini seharusnya pasif. Kita lihat di sini. Passive voice adalah bentuk kalimat pasif. Dia maknanya, bentuknya artinya di ya. Dimakan, ditulis, dimainkan, dipakai, dicuci. Nah, bentuknya harus ada be plus verb 3. Dia maknanya harus ada be. Semuanya yang pakai be plus verb 3 itu berarti maknanya di. Tapi untuk be-nya, dia harus sesuai dengan tenses-nya. Kalau tenses-nya present, nah misalnya dia tandanya verb-nya verb 1 ditambah s atau is. Nah, berarti dia be yang kita pakai adalah am, is, are. Kalau misalnya di verb-nya ada verb 2, kalau mau dijadiin pasif, be yang kita pakai adalah was, were. Kalau present continuous, nah, pakai verb ing, dia bergabung jadi am, being, is, being, are, being. Kalau past continuous, was, being, were, being. Kalau perfect, ada has, have, present perfect plus 3 ditambahnya been. Kalau past perfect juga sama, tinggal ditambahin been. Si modals, contohnya will, would, shall, should, may, might, must, has atau have to, can, could, kita harus tambahnya pakainya be plus verb 3. Lanjut. Nah, mari kita lihat di sini. Ini saya cuma review ya. Mary sweeps the floor. Lihat di sini, verb-nya pakai S. Berarti dia tenses-nya present. Mary sweeps the floor every day. Tinggal ditarik, floor-nya tarik depan, Mary-nya tarik belakang. Perhatikan aja verb-nya. Nah, ini yang kita rubah jadi pasif. Nah, lihat di sini, present-nya masuk ke dalam. Oke. Okay. Lihat. Sweeps-nya. Nah, dia akan sweep, masukin present-nya. Present-nya be adalah am, is, atau are. Kita ambil is-nya karena dia pakai the floor, masukin verb 3-nya sweep. Ini present, ini verb 3. Be-nya present, ininya verb 3. Itu caranya. Berikutnya, Mary swept the floor. Swept verb 2, jadinya dia pass. Floor-nya tarik ke depan, Mary-nya tarik ke belakang. Perhatikan yang ada di sini, swept verb 2, langsung pindahin aja. Masukin be-nya pass. Was swept verb 3. Berikutnya, Mary is sweeping the floor. Sama, ada is-nya, ada sweeping. Berarti tenses-nya present continuous. Di sini juga tinggal masukin is being present continuous verb 3. Berikutnya, coba kita lihat. Coba langsung dijelaskan. Nama saya panggil ya. Malik Audrey Udang. Jawad, Muhammad Jawad. Muhammad Jawad.
Ya, ma'am.
Ya, ayo. Mary sweeps the floor every day. Kenapa jadi the floor is swept by Mary? Jawad? What? Jawad? Jawab. Justin? Justin?
Yes, ma'am.
Ayo, dijelasin.
Mary nomor satu ya, ma'am.
Nomor satu.
Nomor satu, Mary sweeps the floor every day. Kenapa passive jadi gitu? Karena dia aktifnya dia kan simple present, jadi apa objek yang dimaksud itu jadi ke depan, dan karena dia simple present, to be-nya jadi pakai is am are, karena dia subjeknya singular, jadi dia pakai is.
Oke. Okay.
Dan kata kerjanya jadi verb 3, swept. Yeah.
Nomor 2 sekalian, nomor 2 sama nomor 3.
Justin. Lagi, ma'am. Nomor 2, Mary swept the floor, dia itu simple past. Karena dia simple past, jadi kayak tadi objeknya ke depan, dan to be-nya jadi kalau past itu was or were. Tapi karena objeknya jadi ke depan, dia singular, jadi pakai was. Jadi the floor was swept by Mary.
Nomor tiga?
Nomor tiga, Mary is sweeping the floor. Itu dia present continuous. Jadi passive-nya pakai being plus verb 3. Objeknya jadi ke depan, the floor is being swept by Mary.
Okay, thank you. Zaneta, nomor 4. Mary was sweeping the floor. Jadinya gimana kalimat pasifnya? Kenapa was being swept by Mary? Thank you. Let's go. Number 5. Tanita.
Kan aktifnya Mary has swept the floor. Itu bentuk kalimatnya present perfect. Nah, jadi pasifnya itu the floor has been swept by Mary.
Okay. Thank you. Let's go with Mas Lihatu.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, number six. Let's go. Mary must sweep the floor. Jadinya gimana?
Bentar, ma'am.
Mas ditambahin apa?
Dia, ma'am.
Jadinya?
Jadinya Mary Mary must sweep the floor. The floor must be swept by Mary.
Iya, swept-nya verb 3 ya. The floor must be swept by Mary. Oke. Okay. Sekarang kita coba dulu latihannya. Nomor 1 sampai 5 aja. Habis itu baru kita masuk ke pretest latihan 4 ya. Number one, let's go with McBrain. McBrain.
Ya, ma'am.
Ya. Belum kelihatan ya.
What number? What, ma'am?
Wait. Ya, nomor satu. McBrain.
Wait. Why?
Kamu nggak pakai mikrofon, nanti saya panggil ya. Kamu tulis di chat ya jawabannya. Yes, number one. McBrain.
Why does the baby next door keep crying? As usual, it... She neglect by the babysitter.
It neglect. Ayo. Maknanya apa? Seperti biasanya itu diabaikan atau mengabaikan oleh babysitternya?
Diabaikan.
Diabaikan. Berarti kalau diabaikan seharusnya tadi kalimatnya seperti apa kalau diabaikan? Pakai aktif atau pasif? McBrain?
Pasif.
Pasif. Pasif tadi gimana bentuknya?
Is neglected.
Pasifnya tadi gimana, McBrain? Bentuknya harus ada be plus verb t
yang layarnya baliknya ya.
Balik lagi ke yang tadi.
Be neglected.
Berarti be plus verb 3. Sekarang cari yang B-nya pada B plus verb 3-nya, McBrain.
Soalnya nggak kelihatan. Yang D, D, D.
Berarti ada B plus verb 3. Ah, enggak. Cari yang mana yang ada B plus verb 3-nya yang mana?
D. Is to be negative. D.
Ada lagi? Berarti as usual is to be. To be kan berarti akan, kan? Coba dicek dulu. Yang A, is neglecting. Maknanya me atau di?
Me.
Me. Yang B, is neglected. Me atau di?
Di.
Di. Oke, kita masukin ya. B. Yang C, me atau di?
Me.
Me. Coret ya. D. Me atau di?
Me.
Yang delta, McBrain?
Di.
Di. Berarti pilihannya tinggal B sama D. Mana yang paling tepat?
Di.
Why does the baby next door keep crying? Kalau ada does, berarti tensesnya apa? Does. Kalau does, berarti why does the baby keep crying? Keep verb berapa ini?
One.
Verb one. Kalau verb one berarti tensesnya apa tadi? Kalau verb one tensesnya apa? McBrain. Apa di sini? Kalau verb one tensesnya apa, nak?
Present, present.
Present. Tensesnya dia? Present. Jadi mana jawabannya?
Is.
is neglected yang B. Nomor 2. Kita ke siapa yang belum panggil? Dosma. Dosma. Dosma.
Yes, ma'am.
Dari mana aja, Dosma? Enak gitu.
Saya nggak dari mana-mana, ma'am.
Ya sudah. Ayo. Berarti bisa jawab. Lanjut. Ayo. Dosma. Dosma, read the question, please.
Nomor 2 kan, ma'am?
Iya.
I am sure you love the dog over to you by the vet yesterday. Yes, I refused it, but when I went back to him, it had been taken, bukan, ma'am?
Had been taken. Kenapa had been taken?
Karena ini pembicaraannya yesterday, ma'am.
Jadi pas tensesnya apa? Present atau past?
Past.
Okay. Kenapa pakai yang had been taken? Kenapa bukan yang had, bukan yang de, had to be taken?
Nggak tahu, ma'am. Saya kayak pas aja, ma'am.
Lihat di sini, dia kan pas ya. I refuse, but when I went back, berarti dia pas. Masukin tinggal pasnya, pas. Kalau misalnya pas present kan, pas perfect, tinggal ambil been-nya, had been taken. Lanjut. Nomor 3. Evelyn, ya? F?
Yes, ma'am.
Ayo, nomor 3.
It is a rule that only students bringing their identity card, blah, 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 to enter the examining room. The answer is E.
E, kenapa jawabannya E?
Karena kan ini present. Terus
mana presentnya tahu dari mana?
Nyambungnya ke pasif gitu.
Iya. Presentnya tahu dari mana? F?
Karena dari kalimat yang it is a rule.
It is a rule. Ada is-nya ya. Oke. Okay. R admitted. Gabby? Gab?
Yes, ma'am.
Ayo, nomor 4. Keluar masuk, keluar masuk. Jawab dulu.
Koneksi, ma'am.
Iya, cepetan.
Komodos, blah, to be descendant from dinosaurs.
From dinosaurs?
Komodos are belief, ma'am.
Are belief. Kenapa are belief?
Karena pertama dia present, terus dia pasif.
Iya, tentang fakta ya. Oke. Okay. Nomor 5 terakhir, lalu kita coba latihan 4 ya. Oke, okay. The last one is... Melati, come on Melati. Nomor 5 Melati.
Nah, belum kebuka memang soalnya. Belum berhenti. Yeah.
Maaf. Nomor 5, ya. Yeah.
When did the accident happen? When the girls tik-tik-tik from the truck.
When the goods
were being unloaded.
Were being unloaded. Kenapa jawabannya were being unloaded?
Karena itu past. Past.
Terus?
Karena itu juga tensesnya past continuous, jadi were being unloaded gitu, man.
Oh, very good. Thank you. Ya. Kita coba. Saya kirim formnya, kalian kerjakan. Nyalakan dulu kok ini ya, kameranya. I need to take your picture. Come on guys, turn on your camera. Everyone. Yeah. Melita, kemana di sini? Alright. Thank you. So, because I need to send to the report. Yes. Melati, yes. Alright. Smile. 1, 2, 3. Thank you. Once again. Okay. Najma, where's your camera? Faisal, are you okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, thank you, guys. All right, so I will send you the link of the form. The latest of the submission will be 11:55 then. Okay? All right.